just in case we haven't, my name is Jeff, and I'm known as the Viper Man, CUDAChallenger.com and eBodies.org forums. You know, it's finally getting nice out again, and it makes me think of one of my favorite times of the year. In fact, it's just around the corner, and I'm glad you're here today because I want to tell you about something really special we've been working on. I'm calling it A Decade of Carlisle. Now, maybe you know what Carlisle is, but if you don't, well, here, let me show you.
Welcome to Carlisle, Pennsylvania, home of the All-Chrysler National Car Show, often regarded as the largest all-Mopar gathering in the United States. Each year, thousands of Mopars, their owners, show field guests, and vendors flock to Carlisle for this one-of-a-kind event. Everything from the muscle, to the mighty, to the... Well, let's just say there's a lot of cars.
The first time I went to Carlisle was in 2006, when I went with Ashley, who at the time was my fiance. Now we went on a Sunday, which as you can imagine, is one of the lighter days at the show. So we parked outside the fairgrounds, bought some day passes, and just wandered around taking pictures. At the time I was driving a little two-door Dodge Coupe, but besides not really being show-worthy, the thought had never crossed my mind that I would one day have a car worthy of parking on the fairgrounds at Carlisle. Later on that year, something would come along that would change that and so much more.
My 1973 Plymouth Barracuda, which I found less than a mile from my apartment. Bride accessories sold separately. I bought the car just 10 days before we got married. And later on that year, there she was on the Carlisle Fairgrounds. In fact, the first part I purchased from the swaps was this Buy Plymouth badge on the rear valance.
So in 2007, I entered my very first car show and also was a show field participant at Carlisle for the first time ever. But those weren't the only firsts we experienced that year. In fact, we experienced something else, something we never expected.
We would meet a group of people who would impact our lives forever. The wonderful misfits of CUDAChallenger.com. That year was the CUDA Guy Project. On day one, we were introduced to a club who had put their time and talent together to build and donate a car to one of its members and a member of the armed forces. This was the real deal, and it stuck with us. From then on, we were hooked, and for year after year, show after show, we would go on to meet new people from every walk of life, from every state in the Union, and from all over the globe. In seemingly no time, we found ourselves coming to Carlisle not for the cars, but for the people, as these people had become some of our greatest friends. We've had our share of laughs, and we've played our share of pranks. Some of these friends took a special role in our lives. They made it a point to let us know we were family. And when they needed our help, we joined in force to make their dreams come true, even when they weren't with us anymore. Because that's what these folks are all about, and that's the kind of people they've molded us into. In 2009 came the Viper, and Carlisle was forever changed for us, both in the number of cars we had to take to the show, and in the kind of fun we found ourselves having.
Oh, all right.
Like the dork, good.
Yeah, and I'm the dork? Right. Does this look like a dork to you? You old fart. In 2012, we added to the garage as my wife Ashley became O10 Challenger and officially joined the forums. And later that year, well, we added to the family with Melanie Lynn, born Christmas Eve. We started her off right at her first show in 2014, and we wore her ass out. Don't worry though, I have a pretty good idea what I'm in store for, and let's just say, yikes. Anyways, all along we've kept our tradition of making lunch on Saturdays, which we started back in 2008. We've had everything from cheesesteaks to grilled sausages, burgers, and more than one taco bar. In 2011, I started brewing beer, and of course I had to bring that along. Ever since then, it's been a lot of fun coming up with creative names for the show each year. So there's 9 years of Carlisle. 9 years of family, friends, and good food. But a few years ago, I started thinking, what if we made 10? Could I keep a Mopar in the garage for 10 consecutive years? Well, as you're about to see...
There's no shortage of Mopars here. So yeah, we made it. 10 years. And that means it's time to party. And to do that, we're going to go back to the club dinner. Another tradition we've been working on since year number 2.
We organized our first club dinner in 2008 at Your Place Restaurant in Mechanicsburg. We would head back there for a few more years for their buffets, then in 2012 decided to try out Aruga's Sports Bar in Camp Hill. The food was pretty good, the lighting not so great. So in 2013, Ashley and I scoped out a place with a name that couldn't be beat. Dodge City Restaurant in Harrisburg. I mean, it was perfect. The owner loved Mopars, we had a room all to ourselves, and we've been filling the place to capacity pretty much ever since.
Now what I was going to do was tease you guys with all kinds of little details about what we have planned for this year. But instead, I'm simply going to tell you this. It's a surprise! So while a bunch of the details have already been ironed out for this event, we're going to keep them under wraps for a little while because, well, I feel like it. But if you know me, you'll know that whatever we have planned is probably going to be pretty incredible. There are a few things you do need to know though, so here they are. First of all, we're moving the club dinner to Friday night this year. Now we're doing that for one reason, to save us over $1,000. Pretty much took care of that. Secondly, while we wanted to try and pay for this event entirely on our own, the cost got just a little too high for us to pull that off. Also, we didn't want everyone from central Pennsylvania trying to show up to our event. So to try and help out with costs and to keep attendance within reason, we're going to sell tickets to our event for $30 a person. Now that gives you all evening access to our venue, which trust me, you're going to enjoy by itself. It also gets you a full buffet dinner. We're not talking pizza and wings here, we're talking a catered 5-star meal. It also gets you an open bar. That's right, we're going to have a light variety of cocktails, wine, and of course, craft beer. I mean, who are you talking to here? Good news is that tickets are available for sale right now. All you have to do is go to adecadeofcarlisle.eventbrite.com and get your seat today. We're limited to 60 seats for the moment, but if that fills pretty quick, we'll see what we can do to add some more. So this is it, a decade of Carlisle and a party I've been wanting to throw for years. This is going to be the best year ever and an event you won't want to miss. We cannot wait to see you there. Viperman out. Now we're limited to 60 seats for right now, but if we fill that quick enough, we'll do what we can embed with the interface of Fredifier.